happy words out of my mouth, and the meditations of my heart.
Yes.
Be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. And we should rejoice and be glad in it. Knowing that all of our help comes from the Lord. And it is important that we lift up our eyes unto the hills from which cometh all of our help. Anybody here really know where your help comes from?
So nothing better than me.
I understand what he said when he said, when I think of the goodness of God and all he's done for me, my soul cries. Hallelujah. In other words, my soul gets happy. My soul starts praising him. Understand the fact that you can praise your way to victory. And it does not matter what you're going through, what you're dealing with, just praise your way to victory. Because there's victory in your praise. Amen. 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 Now let me give you your 5 minutes. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. There you find these words. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. And we just want to talk a few minutes how to defeat negativism. How to defeat negativism. This is an instructional message this morning. It's not one that's going to get you to feel it all good and want to throw your hands and hallelujah and shout, but it's one that will provoke your thinking. Amen. That will cause you to take a look at yourself and see what it is that I'm doing to either help me to go forward positively or help me to be negative or allow me to stay where I am. But the word of God ought to prompt us to positive action. So the writer said, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. How can we live in a world that's more seems to be more pessimistic than optimistic. So how do we function? How do we deal? How do we remain strong in a pessimistic society? What can I do to make sure that I am optimistic? We have to think on what is negativism? And that is to be negative or to be skeptical in your attitude. Having a negative or skeptical attitude while failing to offer positive suggestions. You remain negative, you remain skeptical, but you do nothing to offer positive suggestions or positive views. So, how do we defeat that? Many of us, we go to church. We sing worship service.
and we'll walk right out of church, and the first thing out of our mouth is something negative. The choir song, all right, but devotion was all right, but the preacher, the sermon, is okay, but I like some of the things he said, but would y'all like biblical, but everything was said. And do you not know that when you hang around people who are negative, you find yourself being negative, and you allow that negative spirit to interfere with you, and it causes you to fall short on your potential. See, we got to learn how to surround ourselves with positive. We got to learn how to accentuate the positive. Well, since we talk about this, I'm glad that I've heard you think. And since I heard you thinking, I'm going to go ahead and see, can I help you here? You said, well, they doing the talking. They are the one with the negative. But can I tell you something, Brother Stan? That if you come to me with negative, and I allow you to bring it to me, yeah, I'm going somewhere. And I sit and listen to it, I'm just as bad as you are. So what we got to learn how to do is that we got to learn how to tell folks that if you don't have nothing good to tell them, keep it moving. Because see, we got to learn to tell.